Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.8 to the public. That means it's available to all iOS 14 supported devices right now. So if you have an iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, SE, you should be able to get the update. Now, if you're not seeing it, you can go to your settings, go down to general, then tap on software update, and it will check for an update and it should be there. Now, if you're not seeing it, tap on automatic updates and turn off automatic updates, and then check again and you should see the update. Now, this particular update is not a very large update. It came in at 312.4 megabytes. That's on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. And this update is about the same size on all the iOS supported devices you'll see here. So it's not a huge update for all of these phones, and we should see iOS 15 fairly soon, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. Now, along with iOS 14.8 that I have on my 12 Pro Max and the iPhone 7, they also released iPadOS 14.8. I have that on the iPad Air, the latest version, as well as watchOS 7.6.2, that's now available to the public, and also macOS Big Sur 11.6. All of those are available now if you're on any of those devices. You should be able to check for an update. However, if you're on iOS 15 betas and you're waiting for that, you cannot downgrade to this without using a computer. Just removing the beta profile, if you have that installed and you're a beta tester or developer, will not allow you to downgrade to iOS 14.8 as you're on a future version, a more recent version. So you would need a computer to do that. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go to general, then about, and you can see the build number is 18H17. And this should be the last version of iOS 14. Last year, we had the update to iOS 13.7 about a week or two before the release of iOS 15, and now we're having iOS 14.8. This is seemingly the last version, with the exception of maybe some security updates, as Apple has said that those that don't want to update to iOS 15 can stay on iOS 14.8 or iOS 14 and instead just go to your settings, software update, and in the future, you'll be able to install just security updates instead of future iOS updates. So they're giving you the ability to get previous versions with future security updates. So instead of updating the whole OS as a whole, you'll be able to get security updates and fixes that are important. Now, as far as this update, there is no new modem update in iOS 14.8. So if you were having connectivity issues with 4G to 5G switching or any of those issues, there shouldn't be any change as far as that. So if the modem was a problem for you, that's generally related to just cellular connectivity, I wouldn't expect anything to change as far as that goes. When it comes to new features, well, in this particular update, Apple has not mentioned any new fix, new features, no resolved issues or anything. So whether or not they fixed anything as far as green tint or any future fixes such as the display, they haven't mentioned that. With previous years, they did fix the green tint issue, but it does not seem to be fixed in this update. This update was released for two reasons specifically, and they have to do with security updates. So if you're not going to update to iOS 15, 14.8 patches some very critical security updates. So if we go to Apple's security website, you can see it says about the security content of iOS 14.8 and iPadOS 14.8. And if we scroll down, you'll see that there are two security patches. Now, the reason these are relevant is there was a Pegasus security breach that bypassed Apple's blast door protections. This was something that was quite serious, and Apple had not released any betas or anything, probably to tip off those that were trying to exploit these updates. So what they've patched, and you can see right here, it says impact. Processing a maliciously crafted PDF may lead to arbitrary code execution. Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited. The description, which is actually the fix for this, says an integer overflow was addressed with improved input validation, and it was reported by the Citizen Lab, which again confirms that this was the same issue, the Pegasus issue that should be resolved. If we scroll down under WebKit, WebKit is related to Safari and the website sort of things handling that in the background. It says the impact is processing maliciously crafted web content may lead to arbitrary code execution. And again, Apple is aware of reports that this issue may have been actively exploited. The fix says a use after free issue was addressed with improved memory management. And this was reported to them by an anonymous researcher. So both of these things are patched in all of the different versions that I've mentioned already, iOS, iPadOS, watchOS, and Big Sur. So all of those things have been patched. attached. And that leads me to, should you install this update? And based off these two things alone, I would say absolutely. This is critical if you're on iOS 14, as this can be exploited and leave security vulnerabilities in your phone. So if you use your phone for payment or anything else, I would highly recommend updating to iOS 14.8. And if you're waiting for iOS 15, you could do that as well, but I would still update to this if you're on any version of iOS 14. Now, when it comes to overall battery life and performance, I wanted to talk about that a little bit, but battery life will take a few days to measure and know if it's any good. Some people were having great experiences with iOS 14.7.1 with battery, some were not. It really depends on how you use your phone, what apps you use, and more. So at this point, it's hard to determine what the battery is. So battery health on this device is 100%, but if we look at the last 24 hours, you can see this is not my main phone as I was using iOS 15. So in a follow-up video, I plan to share the overall battery performance. Like I said, it will take a few days to measure that. Since this is a security update, this shouldn't really affect that at all, but there could be some small fixes or changes in the update overall. Now, as far as iPadOS 14.8, again, don't expect any changes. This is a strict security update. So there's nothing other than what I've already mentioned, and you can see 14.8. It's available and again patches those same security vulnerabilities I mentioned before. Now, as far as overall performance, even on older devices, here's an iPhone 7, the performance should be okay. This should not affect performance compared to iOS 14.7.1, as again, it's a small update with security. So you'll see scrolling is nice and smooth. If I switch between different apps such as music, it opens right up. That's the first time I've opened music on this device. So it's just loading over Wi-Fi. You'll see it's smooth to scroll and the overall performance feels like you would expect. It does not seem to be an issue whatsoever. Now, as far as the benchmarks or overall Geekbench scores, I did measure those so I could share those with you. So we'll go over to Geekbench here. And on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, you'll see that the single core was 1,597 for single core, 4,207 for multi-core. That's actually quite good. Let's take a look at the previous one I ran. So you'll see back in July with the iOS 14 updates, you'll see if we go to this one, we were on 14.7.1. So if we go back, you'll see between the two, we're very similar for single core and exactly the same for multi-core. So the performance again shouldn't really be affected. This just gives you a general overall idea of what to expect. Now let's take a look at it on all of these devices since I ran them on the 7 as well as the iPad Air. So we'll line these up here. And as you can see on the left is the iPad Air, in the middle is the iPhone 7, and on the far right is the iPhone 12 Pro Max. And again, this just gives you a general idea. If you have one of the older devices, you should be in the general ballpark of these scores, 718 for single core, 1,270 for multi-core. So you should expect similar scores to that. Now, as far as anything else, well, tomorrow I would expect iOS 15 release candidate. Generally, after an Apple event in September where they're going to show off the iPhone 13, we'll have a release candidate of iOS 15. Every year they do that, and they could release the final version of iOS 15 as soon as Wednesday or the following week. In the past, it's always been the following week. Only last year was it the next day. Hopefully it's a week or so. It gives developers more time to get ready, and then we'll have the release candidate on the 14th, and then probably the pre-orders for iPhone 13, 13 mini, iPhone 13 Pro, and iPhone 13 Pro Max on the 17th, along with Apple Watch. Then those usually release the following Friday. So all of those things are coming as soon as tomorrow. We should hear all of the dates tomorrow as far as a final release of iOS 15, but we can expect the release candidate of iOS 15 tomorrow. So all of these things are coming up at the Apple event. So that's California Streaming, their new Apple event, and you can watch that online. If you go to Apple's website, we'll go to Apple. You can see at apple.com, it shows the upcoming event tomorrow. And if you want to watch it live, you can watch it at 1 p.m. Eastern time or 10 a.m. Pacific time. You can watch it on apple.com or YouTube as well. So you can just go to the website and watch it from your phone if you want to watch that. So we'll hear all about iPhone, maybe AirPods, as well as an Apple Watch Series 7. So be sure to check that out if you haven't already. So that's everything with iOS 14.8. Of course, this was a bit of a surprise. We did think that it would be coming at some point, but maybe that Apple abandoned it. So it's nice to see that they're actually pushing this release if you don't want to update to iOS 15. So it will be available and you can just stay on that if you want to. Now, As far as iOS 15, of course, we should see that very, very soon. And of course, I'll have videos about that a little bit later. Let me know what you think about iOS 14.8, and if you're staying on that, or if you're going to upgrade to iOS 15 as soon as that's available, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.